So I'm going to stand about one arm length from the makiwara, and I'm going to go into a position with my hips that's deep. Now I just want to isolate only my arms. I don't want to move my body at all. Any excessive movement like this I want to get rid of. And then basically, I'm just going to strike 2, 3, 4, 5. Now I go to Shuto. What a Shuto. Goshi can. And back to punching. Now I'll go low. Multi Shuto. Fudo Shuto. Oh, she can. Okay. So, as you saw in the first sequence of punches, I kept it 5 times on the same side, and then I went to this side. Versus the second repetition with the punches, I went one side or the other. This really doesn't make too much of a difference for me. As long as I'm doing the exercise, you also notice that I'm not hitting this hard. It's very, very soft. It sounds like a lot because the actual pole makes a bit of a banging sound. There's quite an echo here because the wall, there's another room on the other side, so you're hearing a loud noise. It seems like I'm hitting hard, but I'm really not. But again, when I do my strike, my hand is still here. I have tension literally from my tanden, from my center, all the way up my arm into the target. So I'm actually pushing here. I can feel a load in my hips and resistance. So when I hit, I'm not bouncing like this. I'm hitting once, twice, 3, 4, 5. And everything, the moment that strike, I have tension from my center, from my tanden, all the way up into each one of my strikes. And this is progression 1, using 5 different strikes as an example of my makiwara training. Once again, your discipline might have a different set of different protocol or different standards or different requirements for the makiwara training. It may be where you sit and you strike like this with repetition. That's fine. I just want to inspire you to get out there and use a makiwara. Let's go to progression 2 now.